Hello, everybody. I am Drew Duncan. You guys are checking me out live on the program, Fired Up. Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram is all at Drew Duncan Radio. I am wherever you are listening to podcasts. Simply tell your device to play Fired Up by Drew Duncan on iTunes, iHeart, Google, Spreaker, Deezer. Wherever you're listening, I am there. I am brought to you in part by Bly 50 Global Radio, which is online 24/7, 365 at xenofm.com/Bly50 Global Radio. I do post entire shows of the podcast on YouTube. You can find me, The Real Drew Duncan. That's RL, The Real Drew Duncan. I know a lot of people are done and tired of getting new apps and paying for podcasts and all that stuff. Guys, if you want to check it out for free, ain't no shame in it, man. Head on over to the YouTube channel. I hope everybody had a safe night last night. Hope everybody had a fun night last night. Me, I was at home watching sports and getting ready for the show. I mean, I didn't even do like candy or anything like that, which, you know, honestly, I live in an apartment, so, you know, apartments aren't really known for hotbeds of people coming by to do candy or anything like that. So it is what it is. Regardless, I hope everybody had a safe night. And now we've all gotten away from scaring the living hell out of everybody to fa-la-la-la, fa-la-la-la. Let's love everybody, love everybody. Love America. Honestly, today is my birthday. I'm 40 years old. And for me, honestly, Halloween is just the night before my birthday. And everybody always says, why don't you just celebrate it on the same night? Because at midnight, your birthday is there anyway. Just because, okay? It's my damn day, and it's separate, and that's all there is to it. That's why. And I'm going to leave it at that.
That's kind of dumb and petty.
Yeah, well, there's a lot of dumb and petty stuff out there. So there. Guys, big show to get to today. Obviously, we're going to be talking about Deion Sanders. He wants reimbursement for UCLA. So for the moment, while everybody says, hey, this is an inside job, Deion clearly is going for it's not. We're going to be talking about the CFP rankings. We're going to be talking about Harden to LA. The 49ers continue to pick up more defensive assets. We're going to be talking about the Minnesota Vikings. They just traded for Josh Dobbs. We're going to be discussing that. How about Nick Lowry? He didn't like Travis Kelce attending the World Series. We're going to be talking about that. And obviously, we're going to be talking about the Spurs and Suns from last night. Matter of fact, let's just go ahead and get on into that right now. Look, on my TikTok live yesterday, where you can follow me, by the way, The Real Drew Duncan on TikTok, RL, The Real Drew Duncan. One of the things that I talked about, and I've even talked about it on this program before, was, look, I watch teams play against San Antonio, not necessarily because I'm so intrigued with Wemby, but because I want to see how teams measure up against the San Antonio Spurs. Because to me, they are a measuring stick for how good basketball teams really are. Phoenix Suns lost their season opener, then they won a couple of games, and here we are. For the Spurs right now, it's pretty much Wemby and everybody else playing mediocre basketball for 3.5 quarters. That Wemby's making some plays here and there. Some of the guys are making plays here and there. But really, we don't see anything until the fourth quarter. That's pretty much who the San Antonio Spurs have been up to this point. Now, you can say one of two things about San Antonio, right? You could say, well, you got to go a full 4 quarters with them. Because if you want to play San Antonio, you better recognize that they are not going to give up. Let's not forget that Phoenix was up well by double digits in that basketball game last night. And that's pretty much been San Antonio's whole MO throughout their first 4 games of the season. Down by a lot, try to make a comeback in the fourth quarter. In fact, on opening night, Wemby didn't do anything through 3.5 quarters. All of a sudden, in the final minutes of that game, he showed up. Pretty much the same thing last night. Didn't do anything for 3 quarters, and all of a sudden, here comes Wemby in San Antonio. The reason why I say that they're a measuring stick is because that basketball team is so young. The big conversation is all about a rookie. So if you win that game to me in a blowout, it's because nobody was talking about San Antonio going into this season for very good reasons. The other way that you can look at it is, well, if you can't beat San Antonio, if you can't finish them off, if you can't take on a young, inexperienced basketball team and win games, because you should be more versatile in crucial moments, you should be more diverse in how to close out games that you're massively ahead in, you should be more diverse in how to control the clock and different things like that and understand tempo and how to push and how to reel back and maintain your distance in the lead, among other things, in crunch time when the game does happen to get close, how you conduct yourself in those moments, to me, will tell me how good of a basketball team you really are. Now, you could conversely say, look, San Antonio, for as young as they are, is looking really poised. They're looking really good. Wimby's playing okay for three quarters, and then he's showing up. He's learning. He's a rookie. Yeah, look, maybe he's nervous through three quarters and he gets loose kind of like Tim Tebow or something. You know, I don't know what the hell. What I do know is this. Kevin Durant scored his 27,000th point last night. He was the fifth quickest in NBA history to do it, right? You had Wilt Chamberlain at 780. You had MJ at 852. You had Kareem at 965, pardon me. He was the fourth, and then you got KD at 990. And all that was overshadowed by Johnson Steele at the end of that game, where he raked, R-A-K-E-D, raked KD's eyes and got away with it. I mean, Brody went full on Hulk Hogan when he would just rake the Warrior or somebody like that right across the eyes. Only this time, it was real. Somebody actually got raked across the face. The fact that that was not called blows my mind, because honestly, if I'm watching that thing while KD's getting mugged in that corner, it really didn't look to me like anybody was actually trying to take the ball from him. And in that situation, we all know how good of a free throw shooter Kevin Durant is. I mean, I believe it's 90% for his career. So, of course, he's going to hang on to the basketball going, if anybody's going to take these free throws, it's going to be me. And what happens? A foul that didn't get called. He goes to the rack. And then even then, KD gets a pretty decent look at it at the end of the game, right off the lip of the rim. And so to me, that tells me everything I need to know about the Phoenix Suns this season. That they are probably a very mid-basketball team. I've said all along that this team really belongs to Devin Booker. And they're going to be better without CP3, which I think they are. But even then, they're still not good enough. There's just no killer instinct with the Phoenix Suns. And I think, honestly, you could almost relate it to the playoffs from this past season when you had Jokic over there and he's goofing around and messing with the guys during the timeout. And I'm not going to get into whether or not it's legal or not, because it was. They were on the court. Was Jokic just being kind of petty and making fun of everybody? Yeah. Simultaneously, nobody from the Phoenix Suns showed anything. And one of the things I talked about in the playoffs were that nobody on this team is showing any emotion. They're just so indifferent about everything. There's just no fire with the Suns when they get into these situations. They just get soft. S-O-F, capital T, soft.
Man, you don't want to give San Antonio any credit. It's not that I want to give him any credit. It's that I'm not ready to jump on a bandwagon yet. Okay? And even then, thank you very much. Anybody watch that game last night, see what I've been talking about with the comparison. It's more likely to compare, or it's better to compare him to KD than it is to, you know, Tim Duncan and David Robinson. He's just not that type of player. He is more like a Kevin Durant than anything else. There were a couple of crucial situations in that game. I mean, there was the play that Wimby, instead of taking that shot when KD kind of got in his face, he decided to pass it off, and the Spurs got fouled and got sent to the line because they were on the bonus in that moment. To me, that was the play that ended up making the true difference in that game. Because instead of the shot clock running out and Phoenix, those 2 points ended up making a difference. To me, that was the play in that moment towards the end of that basketball game that set everything separate from everything else. It is what it is. Suns are down to 2-2.
Guys, I am Drew Duncan. Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram is all at Drew Duncan Radio. Plenty more to get to with the Vikings and Josh Dobbs. Don't you dare touch that dial.
Block 50 Global Radio, the greatest in hip-hop and rap.
Everybody, I am Drew Duncan. You guys are checking me out live on the program, Fired Up. Do not forget that I'm brought to you in part by Block 50 Global Radio, which is online 24/7, 365 at xenofm.com/Block50 Global Radio. I am on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, all at Drew Duncan Radio. And of course, I am wherever you are listening to podcasts. If you missed the show live, tell your device to play Fired Up by Drew Duncan on iTunes, iHeart, Google, Spreaker, wherever you are listening. I am there. And if you want to, guys, you don't want to do another app, you don't want to pay for subs, go ahead and go on over to the YouTube channel, The Real Drew Duncan. I do post entire episodes there. Still plenty to get to today. We're going to be talking about the CFP rankings. We're going to be talking about the 49ers continuing to add to their defense. We're going to be talking about the Minnesota Vikings. They got Joshua Dobbs. We're going to be talking more college football as, well, I tell you what, this weekend, a couple of big games. And we're going to be discussing that with Coach Prime as well. He wants reimbursement from the Rose Bowl. He's already put that out there. So obviously the Buffaloes are sticking with this is not an inside job. That's all there is to that. In the meantime, boy, I tell you what, Nick Lowry just not happy at all with Travis Kelce and deciding to go ahead and attend a game for the World Series. As a matter of fact, this is the direct tweet from Nick Lowry. Quote, I'm going to just say this once. I adore my Chiefs. I love Patrick. I love Travis. And it's been fun witnessing the Taylor factor as it comes along with not a distraction. However, when I saw Travis watching the World Series in Texas on Friday night before a road game, do I have to finish the sentence? It's not always about staying hungry and humble. We don't know what time he got home on Friday night, but it's a distraction, and it's not a good message to the rest of the team. Travis is a phenomenal, full-of-life, true leader and human being, and one of the greatest Chiefs of all time, period. And one of my favorite people anywhere. We will bounce back. Let this be a lesson. And, of course, he was referring to the performance from Travis Kelce and the Kansas City Chiefs and their loss to the Denver Broncos this past Sunday, which, by the way, I really thought that Denver had a chance to win that game, and I talked about it on Friday before the game. I just thought, you know, Denver's due. I think Denver's due. I think Russell Wilson is tired of losing to Kansas City, and I don't think he's going to stand for that. And the Denver Broncos ended up winning that football game, really not because they played so great, but really because they forced five turnovers in that football game. And let's be honest, everybody was off their game for Kansas City that night. And that includes Travis Kelce. Now, in situations like this, look, it's really easy to finger point and try and figure out something that has been going on. I mean, he even brought up Taylor Swift, and, you know, as long as it's not a distraction, then who cares? Travis Kelce even says that he's been playing better since she's been in the stands and all those kinds of things, and, you know, the analytics certainly suggest so. I'm not going to get into, you know, Taylor Swift. This is not that program, all right? We're not, you know, Hollywood anything. This is Fired Up. This is a sports show. All right. And I talk about other things other than sports, but I'm certainly not about to get into Taylor Swift. No disrespect to Taylor Swift. She's obviously a megastar, but just not something. Number one, I don't really care for her music. I think she's talented, but her music just isn't for me. No big deal. All right. She's not for everybody. So it is what it is. I think what's going on here is he's an old school guy. You know, for those who don't know who Nick Lowry is, especially younger athletic fans, Nick Lowry was a kicker with the Kansas City Chiefs for a very long time. He's one of the greatest kickers of all time, not just in Chiefs history, but in the history of the NFL. And he was there during a time when the Kansas City Chiefs were not the greatest offensively. And it was because of Nick Lowry that the Chiefs won a lot of football games. So I preface that so that way I can make sure that when everybody knows he's speaking from a place of not just being old school, but a place of in Kansas City history and in football history, he's got a right to say something. And that's all there is to it. Now, just because you can say something, as we all know, doesn't mean that you should say something. And as I talked about just a minute ago, it's very easy to, when somebody loses, we've got to point to a specific problem. And as he said, he doesn't know when Travis got home. He doesn't know what everything was. But let's be honest, there is validity to what he's talking about. You've got a road game, you're somewhere else, you're far away from either Denver or Kansas City, really. And you're supposed to travel with the team. It's about camaraderie. You know, everybody's building that relationship together. And Travis Kelce's already had kind of inconspicuous, I guess you could say, auspicious offseason as it is, right? At the beginning of the year in training camp, we saw him in the video where he was just tearing into a rookie, starting a fight and all those kinds of things. Travis Kelce has a checkered past from his days at Cincinnati, which I'm not going to hold against him. I think everybody moves on. Everything is situational. So we'll talk about this season. Then he had the injury, okay? So there was that whole thing. But, you know, the fact of the matter is, I really do not think that it was that big of a deal, but I can certainly see where he's coming from. There are people that are going to tell you, look, man, he's got to live his life. And not everything can be about football 24/7, 365. And let's be honest, the World Series oftentimes is not even going this late into October and into November. We are in November, and we still have the World Series going on. So, you know, Travis caught a game for whatever reason. You know, I don't know if it was because he wanted to hang out. I don't know if he's got some people down there. Whatever the case may be, it's kind of his prerogative. I'm not really one to get in somebody's business. I don't give a damn really about anybody's personal life that's an athlete or an entertainer. I think their life to live is their own to live. I think it's ridiculous. I think we're way too caught up in sagas like that. That's part of the reason why we're not going to discuss Taylor Swift on this program, because I could care less about who somebody is dating. To me, it's got nothing to do with football most of the time, you know? So the fact of the matter is, I'm not into it. Do I think that you can point to it as a reason why maybe he had an off game? It could be. I don't know what Kansas City's standards are, what their practices are. I don't know what, you know, their curfew is. I don't know where everybody's supposed to be at all times. Those are things that, you know, the Kansas City Chiefs, they set the precedents for that. And honestly, I haven't seen anywhere where Andy Reid's talked about it, at least not at the moment of this broadcast. So who knows? I just really feel like it's not the end-all, be-all. I see both sides. For whatever reason, Kelce wanted to be gone away from the team. There could be something else going on. You know, Travis has been getting really big. In fact, it's not even just the Taylor Swift thing. I mean, he filed for these right here, these copyrights. He wants Flight 87. He wants that copywritten. He wants, all right now, he wants that copywritten. He wants Killer Trav copywritten. He wants Kelce's Crunch copywritten. He wants, what is it, Thunder Files or something like that. He wants that copywritten. You know, I don't know, man. I don't know if his show is beginning to go to his head. I don't know if his newfound popularity, you know, because it wasn't that he wasn't already popular, but now let's be honest, by dating Taylor Swift, he's becoming a phenomenon in other aspects. You know, I don't know if this stuff is starting to go to his head or not. It just kind of seemed like at the beginning of the season, there was already kind of a swell there as it was, or as it is. I don't know what's going on with Travis Kelce. What I do know is this, is the Kansas City Chiefs are still a football team that's winning. Okay, they were pretty much in the same situation a season ago. Everybody was saying they weren't going to make it back to the Super Bowl, and they ended up beating what was probably the best team in the NFL, the Philadelphia Eagles. And by the way, they came back in that game after they were getting dominated in the first half. I'm just saying, I think in this particular situation, while I see both sides, ultimately, I err on the side of if he was away from the team and he wasn't supposed to be, then there's an issue. If he had clearance, no, kind of depends on what the rules are for everybody. All right, man, I am Drew Duncan. We're going to take a quick break. We'll be back after this. Don't you dare touch that dial.
Block 50 Global Radio.
Thank you.
Hello, everybody. I am Drew Duncan. You guys are checking me out live on the program, Fired Up. Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram is all at Drew Duncan Radio. I am wherever you are listening to podcasts. Simply identify to play Fired Up by Drew Duncan on iTunes, iHeart, Google, wherever you are listening. I am there. Still plenty to get to today. We're going to be talking about the CFP rankings and staying with college football. Obviously, we're going to be talking a little bit about Deion Sanders. He clearly thinks that this wasn't an inside job, asking for reimbursement. We're going to be talking about the 49ers adding more to their defense. We're going to be discussing Joshua Dobbs to the Minnesota Vikings. Plenty to get to, guys. Do not forget, I am brought to you in part by Block 50 Global Radio, which is online 24/7, 365 at zenofm.com/Block50 Global Radio. I'm wherever you're listening to podcasts. Tell your device to play Fired Up by Drew Duncan on iTunes, iHeart, Google, wherever you are listening, I am there. And if you miss the show live, don't worry about it. You don't want to pay for, you know, more podcasting sites or downloading more apps. Just head on over to the YouTube channel, The Real Drew Duncan, RL, The Real Drew Duncan, and I do post full episodes over there. The news broke late last night that the Raiders said bye-bye to Josh McDaniels. Is anybody really surprised by this? I know that I'm not. As a Broncos fan, I could tell you that I wasn't. I knew that it wasn't going to matter. I knew he wasn't going to succeed, but it is what it is. You know, he didn't last two seasons over in Denver. He didn't last two seasons with the Raiders. And this all goes back once again to the Tom Brady effect. Him looking a lot better than he really was. They had a coach that got that football team with all the stuff going on with John Gruden and the emails and the potential racism and all these alleged things going on, to take a football team and get them to look past that and go 12-4 as an interim coach. And what did the Raiders say? No, bro, we're going to bring in Josh friggin' McDaniels. He's the guy that can get it done. He's going to get it done on a consistent basis. That's what they said. No, 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 sir. Thank you for your time here. Really good looking out. By the way, you're going to go somewhere else and be in an even worse position than you were when you were with our football. Way to go, Raiders. Raider Nation, what are you thinking right now? Look, as far as this past game goes, we all know Devontae Adams was open several times. Can you blame coaching for the way that Jimmy G played? Yes and no. He's either not prepared, or the offensive line isn't prepared, or whatever you want to blame, because obviously Devontae Adams was wide open on a play where he didn't have a lot of time to throw. You have to give Jimmy G credit for his awareness. He just couldn't get the ball there because there was immediately somebody in his face. Simultaneously, I think the NFL should have figured out a long time ago that Jimmy G is not that guy. I said from the beginning, when the 49ers gave him $100 million, that he had done nothing at that time to earn it. And then he went to a Super Bowl, couple of bad throws at the end of that football game, and they lost. I am so sick and tired of, well, so-and-so's been to a Super Bowl. That does not make them a good or great quarterback. There have been plenty of players like Brad Johnson and Trent Dilfer and some others that have won Super Bowls, and they will never even sniff the NFL Hall of Fame. It will not happen. It doesn't mean they were great quarterbacks. It means a lot of times that they were on really good teams. Conversely, you've had really great quarterbacks like John Elway drag mediocre football teams kicking and screaming to Super Bowls that they had no business playing in whatsoever. In fact, three sorry-ass Broncos teams in the 80s. And I'm tired of arguing with the internet about that, by the way. John Elway carried a mediocre football coach, God rest Dan Reeves, and a mediocre football team kicking and screaming. Meanwhile, you've got Jimmy G giving chance after chance after chance. He's not that guy, bro. He never will be that guy, and he's probably next to go, to be honest with you. I mean, I said even just a couple of days ago on this show that I don't know if Jimmy G and Josh McDaniels both can survive this season. You know, I just, where does anybody even begin to think that after this, Jimmy is more than anything than a backup in the NFL? He's not. And he never will be. He shouldn't have been in the first place. And by the way, those three wins that he had, you know, that everybody was so geeked up on, none of those teams even finished with winning records at the end of the season, if I remember correctly. Maybe Jacksonville? Regardless, I know that they beat the Bears in one of those games. It's like, come on. You know, I have no idea why teams and people just get so geeked up on a couple of games. It takes more than a couple of games to decide whether or not somebody's a good quarterback. We have to see them against good defenses. I've been saying the same thing about Brock Purdy since day one. We haven't seen Brock Purdy at any moment be the sole reason why the 49ers have won a game. There are so many overrated players in the NFL that survive basically off of one or two games. It's not even funny. We don't, you know, Tim Tebow got ran out of the league. You know, and mean with one of the worst defenses in the NFL. Everybody talks about that defense. The defense that was ranked 24th in the NFL. Like, are you kidding me right now? And yet here we are giving Jimmy G chance after chance after chance in the NFL. Yeah, and the thing is, it's really weird because it kind of used to have a system in terms of who got fired, right? It used to be you had offensive coordinator, maybe defensive coordinator out the door. Then maybe you'd give the, you know, head coach another season. You know, maybe the quarterback had to go. You know, it was kind of like one of those two had to go. Maybe you let him stick around for one more year. And then depending on what the owner really believed in, it was like a flip of the coin. And, you know, it rarely works out either way. I'm just telling you right now that the Raiders, they have zero clue what they're doing. They're such a bad organization. How they got that stadium built in Vegas, to be honest with you, is kind of a mind blower. I will never understand how the Raiders get such pull in the NFL. They are living off a success that they have not had in years, and the one time they get it, they fire the guy who got him there. If that doesn't tell you everything you need to know about that organization, I don't know what the hell does. You had your guy. What did Josh McDaniels ever do to prove that he deserved another shot at being a head coach in the NFL? I mean, I would, me personally, if I was an owner or a GM, I would have been the guy sitting back and going, I'm going to see how good he does for about 5 or 6 years without Tom Brady. And given how bad the Patriots were for most of the time without Tom Brady and how they've gotten even worse without Tom Brady, I just would have thought to myself, I'm good. I don't think so, Tim. We've got our guy. I think we're good. I could not understand hiring Josh McDaniels for any reason whatsoever. He's barely a decent offensive coordinator, let alone a head coach. Some of the play calls are there, do not get me wrong. But, you know, they've been behind the eight ball in just about every game that they've been in. And everybody was so like, oh, the Raiders are back after they beat Denver. And it's just like, bro, they beat Denver. I just... And I tell you what, one game. It only takes one game anymore for the media and everybody else to be like, man, this is it, bro. And meanwhile, when I say, no, let's wait and see. I'm the psychomaniac who just apparently doesn't really watch football. Tell me you don't watch football without telling me you don't watch football, bro. So what you're saying is you don't watch football. Okay. It's fine. It's fine, everybody. All right, everybody. I am Drew Duncan. Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram is all at Drew Duncan Radio. I am wherever you are listening to podcasts. Simply Data Device to play Fired Up by Drew Duncan on iTunes, iHeart, Google, Spreaker, Deezer. Wherever you are listening, I am there. We've still got plenty to get to with the CFP rankings. We're going to take a quick break. We'll be back after this. Don't you dare touch that dial.
Block 50 Global Radio, the greatest in hip-hop and rap.
We drop bows on them, drop bows on them, when we we drop bows on them, drop bows on them, when we we drop bows on them, drop bows on them, when we we drop bows on them, drop bows on them, when we
Cadillac grills, Cadillac mills, check out the oil my Cadillac spills. Matter of fact, candy paint Cadillacs kill. So check out the holes my Cadillac fills. 20 inch wide, 20 inch high. Oh, don't you like my 20 inch ride? 20 inch thighs make 20 inch eyes. Hoping for American 20 inch pies. Pretty clothes, pretty toes. Oh, how I love these pretty, pretty high class, anything goes. Catch them in the club throwing pretty bowls. Long time draws, long time stalls. Anything make my long time pause. Women on they cell making long time calls. And if they like to juggle, get long dimes.
All my players in the house that can buy the bar on a 20-inch rim with the candy car. If you're a pimp and you know you don't love them bowls when you get on the floor. All women in the house, if you chasing cash and you got some big with a mattress. With your 5'5 boots or your open toes when you get on the floor.
Dirty South mind blown, Dirty South bread. Catfish fried up, Dirty South bed. Sleep in a cop picking Dirty South bed. Dirty South girls give me Dirty South. Hand me down flip flops, hand me down socks. Hand me down drug dealers, hand me down. Hand me down a 50 pack, switch the sweet box. And good fella rich niggas, hand me down stocks. Mouth full of platinum, mouth full of gold. 40 cow, keep your mouth on hold. Lie through your teeth, you can find your mouth cold. And rip out your tongue, cause it's what your mouth told. Sweat for the lemonade, sweat for the tea. Sweat from the hot sauce, sweat from the tea. And you can sweat from a burn in the third degree. And if you sweat in your sleep, then you sweat from me.
All my players in the house that can buy the bar on a 20-inch rim with the candy car. If you're a pimp and you know you don't love them bowls when you get on the floor. All my women in the house, if you chasing cash and you got some big chips with a match in that, with your 5'5 boots or your open toes when you get on the floor.
Getting hit by bars. Keep your girl close cause she's hit by bars. Hit by the Neptune.
During the game last week, I think that's a travesty, and I would expect the NCAA to do something about that. These are college kids. I'm pretty sure they don't think about insurance at this point in this juncture in their life. We've talked about NILs and how to really maintain their finances. We've pretty much given them financial planners and given them the resources for that. But the insurance part of it, we slipped. And we didn't really educate them on that. So I wish, I know the kids would be forthright in what was stolen, and some of our staff members as well. And now all that stuff should be replaced. This is the Rose Bowl. He said the granddaddy of them all, right? I'm sure granddaddy has some money. Grandpa should have some money to get these kids. I'm going to have a list made out from these young men, and I know they're going to be truthful about what they lost so we could try to get that back for them. They may not be able to get the items back, but we should be able to reimburse them. That was...
There you heard it directly from Coach Primetime himself on what he is currently expecting from the Rose Bowl. Guys, I am Drew Duncan, and the program is fired up. Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram is all at Drew Duncan Radio. I am wherever you are listening to podcasts. Simply tell your device to play Fired Up by Drew Duncan on iTunes, iHeart, Google. Wherever you are listening, I am there. Don't forget, I am brought to you in part by Block 50 Global Radio, which is online 24/7. 365 at zenofm.com/block50global radio. Coach Prime says that he wants reimbursed. They're going to make a list. He says his kids will be honest and forthright about what they are missing. He says that it wasn't just his kids, it was staff members. There's all kinds of ins and outs to this. You know, look, again, there are a lot of, I guess we'll call them conspiracy theories floating around at this point, right? There are a lot of people who will tell you this thing is an inside job, that there's literally no chance whatsoever that given cops, security, event staff, and anything else, that there's literally no way in hell that somebody could have just been able to waltz up in there and get away with it. You know, again, one of the things I've talked about is camera crews. Look, there are literally people that their entire job is to sit there and wait in tunnel ways for anything and everything to happen. Arguments, fights with players, coaches yelling, watching guys go into the tunnel because they may be injured, if they've been ejected from a football game. That is very literally what they do. How do you think they get that shot where you see somebody walking into the tunnel? Because somebody gets a little guy in their ear and they tell them, hey, Brody, you've got to hurry up and get out there because somebody just got ejected. Here's the player number. And you've got to get a shot of them as they're walking into the tunnel. So they hurry up, they run out there, and then they stand by the side. They wait for said individual to walk by. They then pan over as they see them walking through, and then they follow them from the backside just so that way you can see them walking into the tunnel. Now, depending on the rules of where they're at, sometimes they are allowed to film from the front. And even then, if they've got enough crews there, which they generally do, you might have one person from the rear, another from the front, and that's how they get both sides of the shot right there. Then on top of that, you've got cameras that are in the tunnels. So very literally, they're watching. Sometimes you're watching from a tunnel cam that is just right there sitting. And that's how you get that angle. And I got to tell you, it just does reek of being a little weird. But obviously, given this statement, Deion Sanders is maintaining everybody's innocence that is involved with the Colorado Buffaloes. Look, I don't really know what side to be on. And here's the thing. Until everything comes out, I am of the opinion that we shouldn't judge this thing one way or the other. Again, when I created my TikTok, what I was saying is that I don't agree with people cheering for the fact that these kids allegedly got robbed. To me, that is just a mind blower. That bothers me. But I have never been of the media frenzy that I am about to take popular opinion one way or the other of anything that happened. It doesn't matter what I think right now. It doesn't matter what I think right now because nobody knows all the facts. All we know is that Prime is wanting reimbursement from the Rose Bowl. He's making a list for said reimbursement. He is claiming that jewelry was stolen from his athletes. He is claiming that other things were taken from his staff members. And again, we know that this is not the first time that this has allegedly happened to Deion Sanders. Now, the last time when it happened at Jackson State, that was a home game. This wasn't an away game in UCLA. But again, you have stuff like, well, don't take things with you to L.A. and it's L.A. and you should know better, or it's California in general and you should know better. Why are you taking things with you? I don't know, bro. Mainly because you're supposed to feel like everything is safeguarded at a place like that. That's why. I mean, let's just keep it a buck. Again, I've attended, I don't know how many live sporting events in my time as a journalist, you know, and especially like you take like casinos. Oh my goodness. A lot of the fights that I've attended have been at casinos. And I mean, sometimes it's a fight even as media just to be able to get into the main area there where people are gambling on the slots and whatnot. I mean, sometimes security is so tight that even doing that is literally a pain in the ass. It all kind of just depends on, you know, who's working the event really during that day. That's what it literally amounts to. Some people see that media badge and they go, man, to hell with you. And they cross check everything that you're doing and they legitimately don't give a damn. Some of them see the media badge and they're just like, ah, come on, hey, man, don't worry about it. You know, to me, it's really all about the experience of the individual. You know, sometimes these guys don't have really great experience with media, which I understand. Sometimes they're new. Sometimes they're young. Sometimes they're just sticklers. You know, it's all just kind of dependent on the overall stadium, how things usually turn out there. You know, I mean, there's a million and one things. What I do know is this. I have never seen security so damn lax ever. That anybody who wasn't credited in some way or the other could just literally waltz in like nothing is going on, snatch everything and just roll the hell out of there. Because the thing is you're literally carrying all this jewelry. Like, how in the hell did you hide it? I mean, to me, you would have had to use gym bags for stuff that you hid. But even then, you're walking in there with what? Nothing in a gym bag and then everything in a gym bag? I mean, to me, the only way to pull that off would have been you've got gym bags that look like they're full of stuff already. You dump whatever's in the gym bags and then you snatch everything up out of there and then you put it back in said gym bags and you go rolling out there and nothing looks any different than it already did. I mean, that's to me the only way that this could have possibly even began to happen. How do you not see somebody strolling on out of that place with all that gear that was taken? You can't just stuff it in your pocket, you know, without somebody. I mean, because everywhere you go, man, they're swiping you for everything, you know. And if somebody let you walk free back there before and, you know, you didn't come up with anything and then you're walking on the way back. Come on, man. I mean, I've been a part of events where, you know, because I have a bad habit, I smoke cigarettes. Every time I would go out to smoke a cigarette, during like a break or whatever the case may be, I would come back in and they would recheck me immediately. They didn't care that I was media. Dude, we got to make sure you didn't go out and grab anything stupid, man. I got to recheck you. So they're running those little buzzer things all across you again. You know, this whole thing is really bizarre and weird, man. It really is. I don't know, but I guess we'll see as it all comes out. Regardless, I am Drew Duncan. Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram is all at Drew Duncan Radio. I am wherever you are listening to podcasts. Tell your device to play Fired Up by Drew Duncan on iTunes, iHeart, Google. Wherever you're listening, I am there. And I am brought to you in part by Block 50 Global Radio. Still plenty to get to. We're going to be talking about the trade for Joshua Dobbs to the Vikings, Harden to L.A., and the CFP rankings. We'll be back. Don't you dare touch that dial.
Block 50 Global Radio, the greatest in hip-hop and rap.
Hello, everybody. I am Drew Duncan. You guys are checking me out live on Block 50 Global Radio. Thank you for tuning in. Do not forget that Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram is all at Block 50 Global Radio. And, of course, they are wherever you are listening to podcasts. I am Drew Duncan. Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram is all at Drew Duncan. TikTok and YouTube is the real Drew Duncan. And I also am wherever you're listening to podcasts. Plenty more to get to. We're going to be back right after this quick commercial break. Don't you dare touch that dial.
Block 50 Global Radio, the greatest in hip-hop and rap.
Everybody, I am Drew Duncan. You guys are checking me out live on the program, Fired Up. Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram is all at Drew Duncan Radio. I am wherever you are listening to podcasts. Simply tell advice to play Fired Up by Drew Duncan on iTunes, iHeart, Google, Spreaker, Deezer. Wherever you are listening, I am there. Guys, still plenty to get to today. We're going to be talking about James Harden, L.A., the 49ers, and they are apparently relying on their defense as they make more trades to the defensive side of the football. We're going to be talking about the Vikings getting Joshua Dobbs. Guys, do not forget that I am brought to you in part by Block 50 Global Radio, which is online 24/7, 365 at zenofm.com/Block50 Global Radio. Also, they are on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, and TikTok, all at Block 50 Global Radio. And if you want to listen to the podcast, if you miss the show live, then you can always go ahead and head on over to The Real Drew Duncan. That's RL, The Real Drew Duncan. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. I'm loving it. I don't know why that went into my brain, but my inner monologue won. CFP rankings. Boy, I got to tell you what. First of all, Kirk Herbstreit, how did that taste? Boy, the look on his face when he said that Michigan was better than Ohio State. Oh, man. He didn't want to have to admit that one out loud, did he? Oh, boy, the disparity. The absolute disparity. The look on his face, just, they're not. Michigan is. They're the most complete team. The look. It's okay, bro. All right? It's okay to say that Ohio State's not the end-all, be-all. I get that it's your alma mater, but come on, man. Denver and Philly, those are my teams in the pros. I tell you when they're bad. All right? Let's just stop with it, okay? I get it. I know what it is, bro. But it's okay to say that somebody's just not that great sometimes. On to number two here. Boy, I tell you what. Well, obviously, they're relying on resume. Are they? Are they really relying on resume? Because Air Force was ranked dead last in the initial CFP. Dead last. Aren't they an undefeated football team? I really despise the New Year's Six Bowl. I really do. If you ask me, it's actually kind of a disgusting look from the NCAA. Because what you are doing is very literally telling Central Florida, Air Force, Houston, you are literally telling them, hey, man, we want you kids to give your best. That's what we want you to do. We want you to give your best. Oh, you went undefeated? Your best isn't good enough. I don't know where you thought that was the case, bro. Oh, you didn't listen to how we felt about the CFP from the beginning? No, we were never going to allow you in here. Come on. What? No. Don't you know Alabama has quality losses? You think you've got wins when Alabama's got quality losses? What planet did you wake up in, compadre? Certainly not the one that says reality. Boy, I tell you what, it's frustrating. It's really damn frustrating because it should signal the fact that the NCAA doesn't really give a damn about anything other than making money continuously. Oh, look, we're going to let them have the NIL deals. Isn't that nice of us? After you made those kids indentured servants for how many years? Get serious. And now you're telling them, hey, man, if you want to be a premier athlete and go to the NFL, not only do we need you to be with a blue blood so that way we can better promote you, especially for when it comes to the Heisman, which basically we might as well call what we think is the best quarterback, which there's already an award for that, by the way, but we're going to go ahead and make another one for them called the Heisman. And what we're going to do is, if you're not somewhere like UCLA or USC or Oklahoma or Texas or Notre Dame or Alabama, we're not even going to bother to consider you. I'm surprised Michael Penix Jr. being in Washington has an opportunity, which, by the way, they were ranked number five, barely ahead of Oregon, a football team that they beat, by the way. And by the way, there are other football teams that beat other teams, and even though they won the head-to-head, they're still being told they're not that good. Resume literally has nothing to do with this, because if resume had anything to do with it, then Michigan wouldn't have even been in the top 10. I don't want to hear it. Well, they've been blowing out their teams. Great. We'll see how Michigan does down the rest of the road here when they've got to play Penn State and Ohio State. I guess we'll wait and see on that. But it is frustrating, and I think it's annoying to call it a New Year's Six Bowl just trying to say, here's a pat on the back. I don't care if they get blown out. Do you understand? If Air Force runs the gauntlet and they go undefeated, then they have earned the right to play in a college football playoff, especially if everybody in front of them has lost a game. If they are undefeated, they earn the right. That's all there should, that should be the criteria. Does anybody remember BYU being a national champion in the 80s? When in the hell did it all change? Is there that much money invested in these teams? I get so damn tired of it. I really do. There's nothing to me more frustrating than hearing the justification of Michigan and that soft-ass schedule that they've played. And then being told whatever Air Force is doing is just not good enough. To hell with you. How about that? I don't want to hear it. If they're undefeated and the other teams that are in only have one loss, I don't care if it's only one loss. They didn't do their job and go undefeated. The other team did. When are these other teams going to get their legitimate shot? When Cincinnati finally got in, I told everybody, the committee's not waiting for Cincinnati to win like they are other teams. They are waiting for them to lose. And that is exactly what this committee is doing. They are waiting for Air Force to lose so that way they don't have to deal with it. And again, this is the issue with preseason polls because it puts everybody else behind the eight ball. Air Force is ranked higher in the AP and in the coaches poll than they are in the CFP. I'm so over it sometimes with the college football playoff. If you're undefeated, then you get a chance. And I don't want to hear, well, they're going to get blown out. First of all, Cincinnati really didn't get blown out. For anybody who watched that football game, you would know exactly what I'm talking about. On defense, they played Alabama outstandingly. They just couldn't get enough for offense. The defense was not the problem in Alabama. It was the quarterback play. And that defensive line for Bama, those four guys were the MVP of that football game. I don't give a damn what anybody says. They were the best players on the field that day. It's no worse than what happened with Washington. It's no worse than what happened with Michigan State. It's no worse than OU showing up in three out of their four games and getting absolutely obliterated in the CFP. All double-digit losses except for the one to Georgia, which, by the way, they were massively ahead in that game and blew that lead and got beat in overtime. No worse than what happened to Notre Dame. No worse than what happened to Notre Dame in the BCS championship game. I just... If you are not annoyed with it, I question what kind of football fan you are. I really do. Central Florida should have got their shot. What are you afraid of, man? What are you afraid of? I tell you what, I almost wonder if we should put people on these committees that literally have nothing to do with football. Just people that, you know, I would almost say let's get a room of 20 people in there that didn't even bother with college. They're just fans. I'll tell you what, I would have a hell of a time in that committee room. A hell of a time. All right, everybody, I am Drew Duncan. Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram is all at Drew Duncan Radio. I am wherever you are listening to podcasts. Simply Tad Advice to Play Fired Up by Drew Duncan on iTunes, iHeart, Google, Spreaker, Deezer. Wherever you are listening, I am there. Still plenty to get to. We're going to be talking about Harden to L.A., the 49ers still beefing up their defense. We're going to be talking about the trade from the Minnesota Vikings. They have acquired Joshua Dobbs. Guys, don't forget I am brought to you in part by Block 50 Global Radio. Block 50 Global Radio is on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. All at Block 50 Global Radio. We'll be back. Don't you dare touch that dial.
Block 50 Global Radio.
everybody. I am Drew Duncan. You guys are checking me out live on Block 50 Global Radio. Thank you for tuning in. Do not forget that Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram is all at Block 50 Global Radio. And, of course, they are wherever you are listening to podcasts. I am Drew Duncan. Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram is all at Drew Duncan. TikTok and YouTube is the real Drew Duncan. And I also am wherever you're listening to podcasts. Plenty more to get to. We're going to be back right after this quick commercial break. Don't you dare touch that dial.
Block 50 Global Radio.
Hello, everybody. I am Drew Duncan. You guys are checking me out live on the program, Fired Up. Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram is all at Drew Duncan Radio. I am wherever you are listening to podcasts. Simply tell device to play Fired Up by Drew Duncan on iTunes, iHeart, Google, Spreaker, Deezer. Wherever you are listening, I am there. Still plenty to get to. We're going to be talking about the Vikings trading for Joshua Dobbs. We're going to be talking about the 49ers continuing to beef up that defense. Guys, I am on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram again, Drew Duncan. I am on TikTok, The Real Drew Duncan. And I am on YouTube, The Real Drew Duncan, where if you don't want to listen to it on a podcast after the show is live, if you don't want to pay for subscriptions or whatever the case may be, no worries. Go ahead and slide on over to the YouTube channel, The Real Drew Duncan. I do post the entire episodes over there. I also do a lot of other things on YouTube as well, more than I really do anywhere else. I do like little short films over there, short documentaries on sports. I do a lot, more with video editing and videos and more cool stuff over there, but If you guys just want to listen to the podcast only, it'll be pretty obvious because it's, you know, usually 2 hours long on there. I don't have time anymore to edit it down to the hour and 20. So I just generally, you know, put in some already predetermined music in there, just upload it and go, man. I just have so much stuff to do now. This is such a busy time of season. So I apologize. Just, you know, fast forward for a couple minutes, man. You'll be all right. In the meantime, James Harden, L.A., I know I'm a little late to the party on this. I mean, I immediately made a post on social media about it, but I really didn't get a chance to talk about it yesterday on the program. So many other things going on. I know that this is really huge news, obviously, but just a lot going on. And plus, you know, it kind of broke after everything else. But regardless, James Harden to L.A., you know, look, I'm not going to get into the trade details. To be honest with you, especially in this trade, a lot of it is boring anyways, okay? What is the meat of James Harden being in L.A.? The meat of it is, first of all, the 76ers finally get rid of that distraction, and they can just go back to being a basketball team, hopefully, right? One of the things that I've talked about is him being back with the team, especially given the NBA rules. Nobody really had much of a choice in that matter, and I think that's why the 76ers decided to go ahead and pull the trigger and just say to hell with it, because they just want to get rid of the distraction. We know we're not going to get what we want. It doesn't matter at this point. We don't want him here with the team. We don't want him traveling with the team. The NBA is going to make us have him travel with the team. Okay, bro, then I just want him gone. Whatever we got to do, let's call LA again and see what they're willing to give us. That's all there was to it. That's exactly what it was. I mean, come on, man. There was literally no other thing for LA about it than that. That's legitimately the story. And the thing that I talked about is you've got a locker room that is divided. You've got a locker room that when he's there and they're walking around, they're on his side, they're all kind of chilling and doing their own little I'm on the side of James Harden thing. But then you've got the other half of the locker room's going, dude, I'm not really with what he's doing. The rest of us were here. It's like this everywhere that he goes. Can we just, you know, all be a team and play basketball? Everybody else has got to follow the same rules, my man. Okay. So now you're in this pickle. And at some point, you have to just be willing to say, to hell with it, go be somebody else's issue. Because we don't need you here from film study. We don't need you here for walkthroughs. We have no intention of playing you. Why are we paying you? We're literally paying you to do pretty much nothing. We are paying you to act as if though you are going to be prepared to play basketball, basketball that we don't want you to play because we don't want you to be a distraction with the team, but we don't have a choice thanks to the NBA. So what they did was, is they just ended it, got him out of Dodge, hoping that the team can maybe have a conversation about it, drop it, and then that be the end of it, and everybody just moves forward. Now, there's still going to be lingering effects. There's still probably going to be some conversations about who was on Harden's side and who wasn't. There's still going to be conversations probably about Daryl Morey, who was on his side and who wasn't. But the thing of the matter is you've gotten pretty much rid of the instigator, supposedly, in this whole situation. What did you get out of it if you're the LA Clippers? You got your big three, I guess. That's about it. I'm not going to say that you've got a rejuvenated James Harden. I'm not going to sit here and pretend that James Harden is going to give anything to the Clippers that he hasn't given anybody anywhere else that he's been. And here's the thing. Once again, we see him teaming up with somebody that he's probably not going to be the number one. He wasn't going to be the number one in Brooklyn with KD. He wasn't going to be the number one in Houston after a while with some of the people they were bringing in there. He wasn't going to be the number one when he was with Joel Embiid in the 76ers. And he's damn sure not going to be the number one in L.A. as long as Kawhi stays healthy. If Kawhi plays basketball, which I think he's only played, what, 31% of the games or something like that on his contract. So basically, you've literally just acquired problems in one instance. Man alive, I would have laughed if somebody would have called me and said, hey, man, we got James Harden. I just would have been like, dude, do you know that we've already got a guy who hasn't even played 40% of his contract over here? Do you know that? Do you know that we've already got that? You think we want another problem? Are you smoking right now? You cooking? Quote Dave Chappelle, man, you cooking? Hell no. What? I would have been Stone Cold Steve Austin. What? 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 Hell no. That's how I would have dealt with that phone call. You got to be tripping, thinking I would have wanted Kawhi and James Harden on the same basketball team. This literally does nothing for LA when it boils down to it. You think I'm going to sit around and sugarcoat it? Think I'm going to give you, well, what's going on in LA is now, you know, they've reunited and now their glory days could return and you've got Kawhi Leonard and, oh, look at it all go come together now. Can I get an amen, brothers? No, I'm not going to do any of that. It's ridiculous to think that this is going to work out because it's not. The Clippers literally just got worse. That's what they got. They literally just got worse. And even if they got slightly better, let's pretend that that happened. You know what they got in the playoffs? Nothing. Kawhi's a proven winner in the playoffs. He's got NBA rings. He carried the Spurs after their main guy was gone. And if he hadn't got hurt playing against the Warriors, let's not forget that that stacked-ass roster in Golden State was getting obliterated by Kawhi Leonard before he went down. And there were theories back then that the Warriors did that on purpose. At least at the bare minimum, Kawhi Leonard, he's also an NBA Finals MVP. When has James Harden ever even sniffed the NBA Finals, Brody? Oh, I know, when he was with Kevin Durant and was in his shadow, and he tried to make it all about himself in the NBA Finals, and all those turnovers and him playing sloppy basketball is why the Oklahoma City Thunder partially were in the situation that they were in. Let's not forget that they had multiple games in that NBA Finals where they were up by double digits. If I remember correctly, two of those games, they were up by more than 20 points. But on average, in those finals, Harden turned the basketball over by himself 14 times. That's what you got. That's what you got. And then you've also got Kawhi over here that basically, if he just doesn't feel like it, doctor says I can't go. Laughing all the way to the bank. That's what you just got in Kawhi Leonard. You didn't get anything spectacular with Kawhi Leonard and James Harden and nothing. In fact, you just gave yourself more drama. That's what you gave yourself. And if you want people talking about the 70 or the Clippers in a negative light just to try and get people to talk about you, congratulations, you succeeded. But that's literally about all you really got. So I don't anticipate anything special. I may eat my words, but kind of doubt it. Go to the playoffs. James Harden will have like one or two really good games. And then he'll just throw his hands up and go, eh, you know what? I really don't want to be here anymore. I hate these guys. Everybody, I am Drew Duncan. Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram is all at Drew Duncan Radio. The show is called Fired Up. Tell your device to play Fired Up by Drew Duncan on iTunes, iHeart, wherever you're listening. If you missed the show live, I am there. I'm brought to you in part by Black 50 Global Radio, which is online 24/7, 365 at zenofm.com/Block50 Global Radio. Still more to get to with the 49ers. We'll be back. Don't you touch that dial.
Block 50 Global Radio, the greatest in hip-hop and rap.
Hello, everybody. I am Drew Duncan. You guys are checking me out live on the program Fired Up. Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram is all at Drew Duncan Radio. I am wherever you're listening to podcasts. If you miss the show live, take advice to play Fired Up by Drew Duncan on iTunes, iHeart, Google, Spreaker, wherever you're listening. I am there. Don't forget, I am brought to you in part by Block 50 Global Radio, which is online 24/7, 365 at zenofm.com/Block50 Global Radio. They are on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, and TikTok, all at Block 50 Global Radio. I am on TikTok, The Real Drew Duncan. That's RL, The Real Drew Duncan on TikTok. In addition, I am on YouTube, The Real Drew Duncan, RL, The Real Drew Duncan, where I do post entire episodes of the show. In addition, I do a lot of other things on YouTube, but at least I try to make time to do other things. I can't always, you know, I mean, some of those videos, man, it'll take me 8, 12, 13, 15 hours to edit, man. So it's just kind of when I'm able to buckle down and actually make the full time, but I do some other things on YouTube, but, you know, again, I'm not getting paid for anything on there, so you don't have to subscribe or anything like that. All you got to do is just follow me or whatever and then click the notification button, and every time you want to hear somebody talk about sports for free, especially if you miss the show live, go right on ahead. Still plenty to get to with the NFL. Trying to figure out, you know, I really didn't know what I was going to go with next, but I think I'm going to stick with Minnesota, Josh Dobbs. Look, how that dude has a career in the NFL still right now is kind of mind-blowing to me, let alone a starting job in the NFL. Now, look, to be fair, he hasn't exactly been terrible in Arizona, but obviously Arizona, they're sticking at least for the rest of this season with their guy Kyler Murray. Arizona, you know, one win with Joshua Dobbs over the Dallas Cowboys. I think that kind of gave him a little bit more in the NFL, a little bit more leeway, a little bit more time. But let's not remember, up until a year ago, he literally had like 7 passing yards in the NFL, okay? So how this dude is finding work is kind of beyond me, but things have been kind of working out for him in Arizona. And look, let's be honest, you know, Minnesota is kind of in a desperate situation, you know? And I you know, you've got to have 3 quarterbacks on the roster. I mean, at least 2 going. So at some point, you've got to just sit back and you have to think to yourself, look, I'm going to do something. I don't know what I'm going to do. Who's available out there? And Arizona, knowing that they're not going to go anywhere with Josh Dobbs, they're just like, look, yeah, we'll give you a good deal on him. That's that. You guys will get what you need. We'll get what we need. We'll, you know, we'll stick with who our third guy is. We'll just bring him on up and no big deal. And then honestly, probably at the end of this season, I'm looking for them to deal Kyler Murray. I just think that with the NFL draft and all the potential that's out there going into this NFL draft anyway, not necessarily saying Caleb Williams, but, you know, the potential that's out there for other quarterbacks, I honestly don't see them keeping Kyler Murray. And even then, I don't see them keeping Kyler Murray either. You know, even, let's just say they can't get somebody like that of that caliber. I think eventually they deal him. And, you know, they try to get some better picks, some more picks, maybe our second, you know, pick or third pick or something like that in the first or second round. You know, Kyler Murray's been so hit and miss, it's going to be really difficult to get anything really spectacular for him. But I just think that with Minnesota, this is obviously a necessity move. Clearly, there's no free agents out there that I don't think they really want to go after. So, yeah, Colt McCoy, I mean, what are you going to do, you know? At least at this point, Josh Dobbs has been playing football. You know, Carson Wentz, what are you going to, I mean, come on. So at this point, Josh Dobbs has been playing football, and you know that he's warmed up and he's ready to go whenever you need him. So there's that. The 49ers, last minute, they get Chase Young. They got rid of Montez Sweat. They let him go to Chicago. Look, I think it's obvious that the 49ers are all in on their defense. And the reason that they are all in on their defense is pretty simple. Because I think all along the 49ers knew exactly who Brock Purdy was. I think they knew that he was a very mediocre quarterback that was being carried by a very good situation. And I think that they really wanted to rely on their defense and the people around him and the fact that Brock Purdy was coming at a cheap price. What is it, 870K? You've got guys right now in college football that are making more money than he is. And Shedeur Sanders, supposedly one of them. You know, I mean, come on, you've got Hutchins over there. He went from Michigan to KU for basketball, $281,000. Allegedly, you know, the initial number was like $100 million or something like that. And then somebody said $4 million and somebody said $3 million. He maintains that it's $281K. Regardless, he's making $281K. You got Brock Purdy, $870. And there were reasons for that. I kept trying to explain to people there were reasons. I mean, come on, man. Jimmy G got 100 mil after, five games? So, you know, let's just keep it a buck here real quick. If Brock Purdy was everything everybody said he was, and the 49ers, predicated upon their evaluation of him, still didn't think that he was, and they continue to build the defense, they obviously see where this season is going. What they are saying is, look, if we get into a jam offensively, and we've obviously seen that we're very capable of that, we want to make sure that our defense is going to have really good depth. We want to make sure that our defense is ready and capable. We want to make sure that if anybody gets hurt, we've got guys in there to back up. We've also got players that we can keep fresh and a good rotation. That's an important thing now in defense, you know, with the consistency and the hurry-up offense and whatnot. For just about every team playing football from peewee leagues all the way to the NFL. That's a big part of it. And the other thing is we're beefing it up. If you're going to beat us, you are going to earn every second of that. And we want to make sure that our first and foremost thing that we do is stop the run for anybody who thinks that they're going to be able to do it on us. And we want to put massive pressure on every quarterback that we face. We want him in your grill every time. And also, we want to try and take a little bit of pressure off of Bosa. If we can get somebody in there that you've got to account for lining up on just the other side of that football, well, then, you know, you've got a two-headed monster on that defensive front. It's going to be a problem. That sounds to me like exactly what the 49ers are trying to do. And I can't blame them. Again, there's not a game where the 49ers have played and you thought to yourself, man, dude, it is a really good thing that we had Brock Purdy. Had it not been for us having Brock Purdy, we just wouldn't have been any good. We wouldn't have won that game. Thank goodness we got Brock Purdy. Thank you, football, for giving us Brock Purdy. Never happened. Not once in the history of everdom did it happen. It was on the 5th of February. You understand? Nobody thought that. Nobody. Come on now. And again, the 49ers, I mean, and look, especially when you lose three games in a row, and defensively all of a sudden you got kind of exposed a little bit, right? So now you've got to try and figure out what's going on defensively that is really hurting us. We need answers, and we need them now. It's a big part of it, man. That is a huge part of it, as a matter of fact. So I think really for my money, the 49ers are doing the right thing. But right now, they've also got to figure something else out on the offensive side of the football. And I'll be honest with you, I think at the end of this season, Brock Purdy is probably gone or is a backup with Frisco if he wants to stick around. Because they are going to try and get somebody. And with Kyler Murray probably not going to be surviving and going into next year with the Arizona Cardinals, I would not be surprised if Kyler Murray actually ended up in San Francisco, if I'm keeping it honest with you. I don't think they want to trade him to a division rival team, but when all is said and done, who else is going to take Kyler Murray as a starter for what you're going to want to get? And I think, honestly, Kyler Murray would probably flourish in that situation with Christian McCaffrey. I think it would be his style of offense all day, every day, and he'd have somebody with a better arm. I mean, I'm just keeping it a buck. I think he could be rejuvenated if he went to a place like Frisco. So if I'm the 49ers, I'm looking at Arizona and I'm going, we know you guys want to get somebody in the draft. Make us an offer on Kyler Murray because we're done with Brock Purdy. unless he do something spectacular. Nah. All right, guys, we got to pay these bills. We'll be back. Don't you touch that dial.
Block 50 Global Radio.
We drop bows on them. Drop bows on them. When we. Woo! We drop bows on them. Drop bows on them. When we. We drop bows on them. Drop bows on them. When we. Oh, oh, oh. We drop bows on them. Drop bows on them. When we. Cadillac grills. Cadillac mills. Check out the oil my Cadillac spills. Matter of fact, candy paint Cadillacs. So check out the holes my Cadillac fills. 20 inch wide, 20 inch high. Oh, don't you like my 20 inch ride? 20 inch thighs make 20 inch eyes. Hoping for American 20 inch pies. Pretty clothes, pretty toes. Oh, how I love these pretty holes. Pretty high class, anything goes. Catch them in the club throwing pretty bowls. Long dime draws, long dime stalls. Anything make my long dime pause. Women on they still making long. They like to juggle, get long dimes.
All my players in the house that can buy the bar on a 20-inch rim with the candy car. If you're a pimp and you know you don't love them clothes when you get on the floor. All women in the house, if you chasing cash and you got some big with a mattress with your 5'5 boots or your open toes when you get on the floor.
Dirty South mind blown, dirty South bread. Catfish fried up, dirty South bed. Sleep in a cop picking dirty South bed. Give me dirty South. Hand me down flip flops. Hand me down socks. Hand me down drug dealers. Hand me down. Hand me down a 50 pack. Switch the sweet box. And good fella rich niggas. Hand me down stocks. Mouth full of platinum. Mouth full of gold. 40 cow. Keep your mouth on hold. Lie through your teeth. You can find your mouth cold. And rip out your tongue. Cause it what your mouth told. Sweat for the lemonade. Sweat for the tea. Sweat from the hot sauce. Sweat from the tea. And you can sweat from a burn in the third degree. And if you sweat in your sleep, then you sweat from me.
All my players in the house that can buy the bar on a 20-inch rim with the candy car. If you're a pimp and you know you don't love them clothes when you get on the floor. All my women in the house, if you chasing cash and you got some big teeth with a matching ass. With your 5'5 boots or your open toes when you get on the floor.
Getting hit by bars. Keep your girl close because she's hit by bars. Hit by the Neptunes, hit by guitar.
Hello, everybody. I am Drew Duncan. You guys are checking me out live on Block 50 Global Radio. Thank you for tuning in. Do not forget that Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram is all at Block 50 Global Radio. And of course, they are wherever you are listening to podcasts. I am Drew Duncan. Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram is all at Drew Duncan. TikTok and YouTube is the real Drew Duncan. And I also am wherever you're listening to podcasts. Plenty more to get to. We're going to be back right after this quick commercial break. Don't you dare touch that dial.
Block 50 Global Radio.
All my life I've been going against the grain. Seems like I do much better in the rain. But I can't sit here wait for things to change. Gotta get up, go get no pain, no pain.
All I know is going beat the block and it won't stop, yeah. I gotta get the legal paper, can't make it with the crack rock, yeah. Still praying for my dogs in the trap when the gat clap, yeah. Double barrel, double shots in his brain, in his lap, lap, yeah. You will never see a protest form, don't nobody really care. In America, you can get killed with your hands in the air. Popo hit him with the one shot, made his body drop, yeah. The one shot like pop, pop, freeze, pop, 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 yeah.
All my life I've been going against the grain. Seems like I do much better.
up in the morning, eyes open and it feel like a test. Gotta lift your head out the bed like lead on your chest. You got more money than your money, never get enough rest. God, I'ma give you my best, relieve my stress. My homegirl gotta feed both the babies and she all on her own. And even when a baby said she can't really afford to stay home, her baby daddy wasn't really buy nothing and he left her alone. Mama still kept it real, go get her, can't stop her, she gone.
All my life I've been known as
get on a dollar bill, I gotta get more, yeah. The devil trying to hold my wallet, but you know we gotta let go, yeah. People giving up on life, gotta stay in the fight, like, yeah. The world dark, so I'm walking in the light with Christ, like, yeah. Stand up like you know God got your back, like, yeah. Look in the mirror, say, I'ma go get her, I'ma win her, like, yeah. So you know you can't stop me, he forever paid bail, like, yeah. Like Christ when he took the cheese, walked out of hell like hell.
All my life I've been going against the grain. Against the grain, yeah. So much better in the grain. So you wait for things to change. Wait to change for me, yeah.
Hello, everybody. I am Drew Duncan. You guys are checking me out live on the program, Fired Up. Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram is all at Drew Duncan Radio. I am wherever you are listening to podcasts. Simply tell your device to play Fired Up by Drew Duncan on iTunes, iHeart, Google, Spreaker, Deezer. Wherever you are listening, I am there. I am brought to you in part by Block 50 Global Radio, which is online 24/7, 365 at zenofm.com/Block50 Global Radio. They are also on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram and TikTok, Block 50 Global Radio, guys. I am on TikTok and YouTube, The Real Drew Duncan for both of those. That's RL, The Real Drew Duncan. And of course, on YouTube, I do post the entire episode there and do some other things with YouTube as well that I really don't do anywhere else for the most part, but, you know, it's getting more and more difficult, you know, especially like Instagram, because they've really hammered down on everything automatically turns into a reel, everything. And if it goes over the minute and a half mark, I've noticed they really don't like promoting it for the most part. I mean, at least that's been my experience. So we'll see how that goes. I do like video editing to an extent. I get some pretty nifty ideas, if I may say so myself. And, you know, it's just sometimes you can't cram everything you want to inside of a minute and a half, you know. Kind of is what it is. But quick show recap here, guys. Again, Coach Prime wanting reimbursement. Obviously, he believes in that everybody that's in his camp is innocent. So there's that. I think that's pretty cut and dry. The CFP rankings, look, I kind of went off on a, I didn't kind of, I went completely off the rails on a tangent about Air Force. So it does upset me. They should at least be ranked higher in order to give themselves a chance, you know, and then the dismissal of which everybody that's doing that CFP show talks about it and talks about them. It's so damn frustrating, you know, it really is. But if they go undefeated to me, they should get their shot. I really don't care. As far as the rankings go, really wasn't too surprised. I didn't think Ohio State would be number one. I did say that there was the possibility given their resume, but I really thought that given, you know, Georgia without their best player, the way that they beat Florida, they would get the number one spot. They didn't get it. Instead, they gave it to Ohio State. I'm not mad at it. I do believe that defensively they're better than most of us have given them credit for. Of course, I think when they play Michigan, it could be a little bit different. But regardless of that, I think that offense is 100% carried by Marvin Harrison Jr. Michigan has got a lot to prove. I think, obviously, I don't know how good of a win Penn State is at this point, given what we've seen from Drew Aller when he had to play a really good defense Part of that, again, to me, was poor coaching. Again, 5 yards a carry on offense from your primary back. Why are you not running the football more? There was no reason for them to throw the football 40 times in that game. To me, that was poor coaching in that situation. So I just, it's really difficult. Did he learn from it? Did James Franklin, the coach, learn from it? Or is he going to, you know, revert back to the same again when they go to play Michigan? I guess we'll see what happens. Alabama, again, I wasn't surprised that they were in the top 10 and kind of par for the course. Obviously, they've got LSU coming up this Saturday, which we'll get into more as the season goes on. The only thing I was kind of surprised on was Washington being number 5. I would have thought they would have been a little bit higher, but obviously the committee, for whatever reason, sees Oregon neck and neck. I'm not really sure why. I guess maybe they just gave them the head-to-head in that situation. I know that Washington hasn't looked great since they've won that game, but let's be honest, nobody in college football has really separated themselves. Michigan has been the most dominant team, but again, they haven't played anybody, but at least you can say they've been the most consistently dominant football team in college football. Everybody else has had really close games against teams that they really should have obliterated. You've already had OU beat by KU, but excuse me, for me, I look at it and I go, you know, I just think that with OU, it's not quite an upset to me. And more than anything, I'm grateful. Yeah, I hate to say what I'm saying, but I just, my experience with OU and the CFP and against USC and the BCS and again, their 10-point loss to Florida, it just, after a while, you have to start wondering, just wait till they get to the SEC. You know, that's all I'm saying. Wait till they get to the SEC. James Harden, L.A., they didn't get better. They got worse. They're dealing with multiple problems now. Two guys who are going to want to be traded and don't want to play, whatever the case may be. They just created more drama for themselves than is absolutely necessary. Look, Nick Lowry going off, which he really didn't go off on Travis Kelce. I thought the way that he said it was very tasteful, very respectful. Again, he's very old school. You're on a road game. You're going against a rival. People are saying that you're not that good. You have a really bad slip. Is it the fault of Travis Kelce for going out? I mean, obviously, as far as being any type of receiver goes on that football team, Travis Kelce is the best that they've got. And I don't think there's any denying that whatsoever. He's absolutely 110% the best that they have. Now, does that mean that Travis Kelce shouldn't take a little bit of him time? Look, I think, honestly, that is up to the Kansas City Chiefs as an organization to decide. Not for everybody else. I think they've got their rules in place for player conduct and doing things like that. And if they disagree with Travis Kelce going to the World Series, then I'm pretty sure they're going to deal with that in-house. I think that's pretty simple. The Suns and Spurs, again, I think that teams playing the Spurs right now are measuring sticks for how good they really are. Inability or ability to finish a game when you're up by points. Inability or ability to be able to finish a game when you're in crucial situations where you stepping up. Inability or ability to basically do what you should be doing from the beginning with a young team, and that's beating the living hell out of them and making Wimby regret going to the NBA. Nobody's done that. They've bottled him up for three quarters for the most part, but in that fourth quarter, he has really showed up. As a rookie, I will say that for him. Again, I'm not geeked on him. I don't get geeked on anybody right out of the gate. That's the way that it is. I think that the Spurs are in a good place potentially going forward over the next couple of years. But again, KD overshadowed 27,000 points scored now in his NBA career, fourth fastest to do it in NBA history. And what happens, he gets robbed. And, you know, he was lit up across the grill. I mean, there's no denying that. So while, you know, this carjacking is taking place and nobody calls a foul in Phoenix, boy, I tell you what, that was a real surprise to me regardless, KD did the right thing by holding the ball there. If anybody's going to shoot those free throws, it should be him. Now, you can say he can get rid of it. You know, by getting rid of it, obviously, it takes a little bit more time off. But you take a big risk with the crossbody toss right there because somebody from San Antonio could come and snatch it up. So, to me, overall, probably the best thing to go ahead and hold it. He was fouled, didn't get called. Regardless, San Antonio should have been in that situation to begin with. Phoenix should have put the game away, and they failed to do so. Josh McDaniels, gone. Adios, compadre. Never knew what he did to get there. The linebackers coach, it looks like he's expected to be announced as the interim head coach. Again, the Raiders, to me, had their guy a couple of years ago, and they wet the bed on the situation. I will never know what caused them to get rid of him. To be honest with you, I don't care. You finally get a winning season in the midst of all that BS that was going on. You finish the year 12-4, and you mean to tell me that you would rather get rid of that guy than at least give him another year, a full year to see what he had? I just... And by the way, you got three times worse when you got McDaniels. And I never saw it. Never thought it was going to be a good thing, but it is what it is. All right, everybody, I am Drew Duncan. Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram is all at Drew Duncan Radio. I am wherever you are listening to podcasts. Simply identify to play Fired Up by Drew Duncan on iTunes, iHeart, Google, wherever you are listening, I am there. I am brought to you in part by Block 50 Global Radio, which is online 24/7, 365 at zenofm.com/Block50 Global Radio. Your local programming is next. Don't you dare touch that.
Block 50 Global Radio.
We drop bows on them. Drop bows on them. When we. We drop bows on them. Drop bows on them when we
go run bows.
We drop bows on them. Drop bows on them when we. Oh, oh, oh. We drop bows on them. Drop bows on them when we
go run bows.
Cadillac grills, Cadillac mills. Check out the oil my Cadillac spills. Matter of fact, candy paint Cadillacs kill. So check out the holes my Cadillac fills. 20 inch wide, 20 inch high. Oh, don't you like my 20 inch ride? 20 inch thighs make 20 inch eyes. Hoping for American 20 inch pies. Pretty clothes, pretty toes. Oh, how I love these pretty, pretty high class anything goes. Catch them in the club throwing pretty bowls. Long John draws, long John stalls. Anything make my long John pause. Women on they still making long John calls. And if they like to juggle, get long Johns.
All my players in the house that can buy the bar on a 20-inch rim with the candy car. If you're a pimp and you know you don't love them clothes when you get on the floor. All my women in the house, if you chasing cash and you got some big with a mattress with your 5'5 boots or your open toes when you get on the floor.
Dirty South mind blown, dirty South bread. Catfish fried up, dirty South bed. Sleep in a cop picking dirty South bed. Dirty South girls give me dirty South. Hand me down flip flops, hand me down socks. Hand me down drug dealers, hand me down. Hand me down a 50 pack, switch the sweet box. And good fella rich niggas, hand me down stocks. Mouth full of platinum, mouth full of gold. 40 cow, keep your mouth on hold. Lie through your teeth, you can find your mouth cold. And rip out your tongue, cause it what your mouth told. Sweat for the lemonade, sweat for the tea. Sweat from the hot sauce, sweat from the tea. And you can sweat from a burn in the third degree. And if you sweat in your sleep, then you sweat from me.
All my players in the house that can buy the bar on a 20-inch rim with the candy car. If you're a pimp and you know you don't love them clothes when you get on the floor. All my women in the house, if you chasing cash and you got some big chips with a match in that, with your 5'5 boots or your open toes when you get on the floor.
Off the list. liquor, getting hit by bars. Keep your girl close, cause she's hit by fall. Hit by the Neptunes, hit by guitar. Afro picks, Afro chicks. I let my soul glow from my Afro. Rabbit out the hat, pulling Afro tricks. Afro American, Afro thick. Overall country, overall team. Overall Doja, we overall clean. Southern hospitality, you overall mean. Overall triple, overall beam. Thugged out, wearing thugged out chains. Thugged out blocks, playing thugged out games. All black tinted up, thugged out range. DTP stay doing thugged out things.
All my players in the house that can buy the bar on a 20-inch rim with the candy car. If you a pimp and you know you don't love them clothes when you get on the floor. All my women in the house, if you chasing cash and you got some big with a match in it, with your 5'5 boots or your open toes when you get on the floor. All my players in the house that can buy the bar on a 20-inch rim with the candy car. If you a pimp and you know you don't love them clothes when you get on the floor. All my women in the house, if you chasing cash and you got some big with a match in it, with your 5'5 boots or your open toes when you get on the floor. We drop bows on them. Drop bows on them when we woo. We drop bows on them. Drop bows on them when we we drop bows on them. Drop bows on them when we we drop bows on them. Drop bows on them when we
throw them bows.
We drop bows on them. Drop bows on them when we
woo.
We drop bows on them. Drop bows on them when we
throw them bows.
We drop bows on them. Drop bows on them when we we drop bows on them. Drop bows on them when we
throw them bows.
Cadillac grills, Cadillac mills. Check out the oil my Cadillac spills. Matter of fact, candy paint Cadillacs kill. So check out the holes my Cadillac fills. 20 inch wide, 20 inch high. Oh, don't you like my 20 inch ride? 20 inch thighs make 20 inch eyes. Hoping for American 20 inch pies. Pretty clothes, pretty toes. Oh, how I love these pretty, pretty high class anything goes. Catch them in the club throwing pretty bowls. Long time draws, long time stalls. Anything make my long time pause. Women on they still making long time calls. And if they like to juggle, get long dimes.
All my players in the house that can buy the bar on a 20-inch rim with the candy car. If you a pimp and you know you don't love them clothes when you get on the floor. All my women.